Hello, my name is Seth Kirz, and I'm a second year PhD student in Dr. Karen Helt's bioseparations lab in the Department of Chemical Engineering. One of our lab's primary objectives is improving the purification of virus particles for vaccine manufacturing. And today, I'd like to introduce you to an extraction procedure we are developing using aqueous two-phase systems, or ATPS, that could one day operate continuously, reducing manufacturing costs and the time to market. Vaccine manufacturing follows a pattern similar to most bioprocesses. Virus particles are produced in a bioreactor, purified from leftover pieces of cells, and packaged with stabilizers and adjuvants. 70% of the production cost tends to be concentrated in the purification steps, and typical recoveries are less than 30%, so my research focuses on improving the downstream segment of the process. Traditionally, purification of virus particles is achieved by tools like filtration, chromatography, or density gradient ultracentrifugation. The problem is that filters tend to plug, chromatography is expensive and can't be operated continuously, and ultracentrifugation is just not scalable. We are proposing extraction by ATPS as a replacement for these methods. Our ATPS are made of polymer, salt, and water, and separate into two aqueous phases at high enough polymer and salt concentrations. Each bioparticle has a different affinity for the polymer or the salt phase, and careful tuning can yield efficient separation. Our study used a small, non-envelope model virus called porcine parvovirus and two phase-forming components already FDA-approved for use in pharmaceuticals, polyethylene glycol, or PEG, with a molecular weight of 12 kilodaltons, and sodium citrate. Here's a schematic of our extraction process. We add PEG, sodium citrate, water, and crude virus broth to a tube, mix, and separate the phases. At this system composition, the virus prefers the top phase, while the contaminating proteins and DNA partition to the bottom. We have a relatively pure virus at this point, but it is in a very viscous polymer that's difficult to process further. To recover the virus, we used a second stage of ATPS at a different system composition that causes the virus to partition to a gentle salt solution ready for final polishing. This heat map on the left shows the binodal curve as a function of PEG and citrate concentrations. Compositions below this line do not form two phases and therefore cannot be used for separation, and recoveries of porcine parvovirus above it are shown as a color gradient. These recoveries are dictated by a complex network of driving forces shown below that I'd be happy to explain further in the question and answer session. We chose a system that gave high recovery of PPV in the top, PEG-rich phase to make the first stage, and another that recovers the virus in the bottom, citrate-rich phase for the second stage. In our experiment shown here on the right, the recovery in the first stage worked quite well, but recoveries in the second stage were much lower than expected. This reduced our overall recovery as well. This may be caused by the PEG molecules adhering to the virus during the first stage and strengthening the interaction between the virus and the PEG-rich phase. So we plan to run more experiments where the virus begins in either the PEG or the citrate to test this hypothesis. Still, despite low overall recovery, this experiment provided a proof of concept result, suggesting that it is possible that with some optimization, virus may be recovered from the polymer with the second stage of ATPS. Our upcoming work will first optimize recoveries in the second stage to improve overall yield in batch mode, and then we will use the system to demonstrate fully continuous PPV purification. As I finish, I would like to thank Dr. Helt and my lab group, the Frederick G. Cottrell Foundation, and the NSF Graduate Research Fellowship Program for their support. And thank you for attending my presentation.